Bonjour tout le monde. I'm joined today by Ministers Anand, Leblanc, Le Boutillier, Hutchins and Fraser. We're here to provide an update on what we are doing to support people and provincial governments in the wake of Hurricane Fiona. As you know, the storm has passed, but thousands of homes are still experiencing power outages, and the scale of the damage means that people are still facing a tough time. Many parts of Nova Scotia and PEI, as well as southwestern Newfoundland, continue to experience the effects and damage left by the winds and coastal flooding. On constate aussi les dégâts des inondations et des vents dans le golfe du Saint-Laurent, y compris aux îles de la Madeleine et dans l'est du Nouveau-Brunswick. Il va y avoir beaucoup de travail à faire dans les prochains jours et les prochains mois pour nettoyer et rebâtir, mais je sais que les Canadiens vont être là les uns pour les autres, comme toujours. I want to offer my condolences to the loved ones of the woman who lost her life in Porto Basque and to the loved ones of the person who passed away in Prince Edward Island. Canadians are thinking of you in these difficult times. Our thoughts are also with people who've lost homes or businesses, people who've been evacuated and aren't sure when they're going to be able to get home, people who are having difficulty accessing services and support due to road washouts and debris, and people with young kids who won't be going to school today. I want, of course, to thank first responders for their incredible work this weekend and the work they continue to do, as well as thanking Atlantic Canadians who, as always, are being good neighbours to one another, looking out for each other, because that's what Atlantic Canadians do. That's what all Canadians do. C'est traumatisant de voir sa maison détruite ou de devoir être évacué d'urgence. Ce sont des moments très difficiles. Je peux vous dire que tout le monde sur le terrain travaille fort pour soutenir les communautés touchées. Hier, j'ai réuni encore une fois le groupe d'intervention en cas d'incident, en compagnie des ministres et des hauts fonctionnaires qui travaillent activement avec leurs homologues provinciaux et avec les communautés des Premières Nations. J'ai aussi parlé au maire de Charlottetown, de Port-au-Basque et de la municipalité régionale du Cap-Breton. J'ai parlé aussi, bien sûr, avec notre équipe de députés locaux qui sont avec les gens sur le terrain. Our government quickly approved requests for federal assistance from provinces. In Nova Scotia, the Canadian Armed Forces are available to clear road links and to restore electricity. On PEI, some smaller communities are isolated and tens of thousands remain without power. The Canadian Armed Forces have arrived to help remove debris from roadways and assist in the restoration of the power grid. In Newfoundland and Labrador, the federal government is helping by providing detailed aerial imagery and mapping of damages. We're also deploying military personnel to support local authorities on the ground. And naval vessels and aircraft are also on high readiness to assist if necessary. The one thing that's been consistent in my calls to premiers, mayors, and MPs is that Canadians are stepping up for each other and helping their communities get through this tough time. I will be visiting the affected regions as soon as possible this week. And I want all people in the Atlantic provinces and Eastern Quebec to know that we are here for you. Justement cet été, j'ai eu l'occasion de me rendre dans les provinces de l'Atlantique pour rencontrer les gens et parler des enjeux qui sont importants pour eux. Et je suis allé particulièrement aux îles de la Madeleine un peu plus tôt, il y a un mois. C'est un endroit magnifique. Les Madelinos sont des gens très accueillants. C'est des gens qui sont toujours là pour s'entraider les uns les autres. Je sais qu'ils sont aussi habitués aux tempêtes, mais celle-ci, elle a frappé fort et on va continuer d'être là pour les appuyer comme on appuie tout le monde dans la région. Je peux vous dire, on va continuer d'être là, pas juste dans les jours à venir, mais dans les semaines, les mois et s'il y a besoin, dans les années à venir. Comme on l'a annoncé samedi, ceux qui veulent aider peuvent se rendre sur le site web de la Croix-Rouge canadienne pour faire un don et notre gouvernement va égaler le montant des dons pendant les 30 prochains jours. If Canadians want to help, you can donate on the Canadian Red Cross website and our government will match your donations over the next 30 days. I know Canadians are watching with consternation, either the images that they've seen or, like so many Canadians, having friends and family members in Atlantic Canada that we've been worried about. It's an opportunity to step up and give what we can to support people on the ground. Like I said, the government will match those donations to the Red Cross. En terminant aujourd'hui, je veux parler de la situation en Iran. Malheureusement, les mépris pour les droits de la personne en Iran n'est pas quelque chose de nouveau. In the wake of the horrific downing of PS 752, the Iranian regime refused to be held accountable, but our government was and is relentless in the pursuit of justice for the families of the victims. We will stop at nothing to ensure that this regime is held to account and that we will support the families until justice is served. We've seen Iran disregarding human rights time and time again, and now we see it with the death of Mahsa Amini and the crackdown on protests. To the women in Iran who are protesting and to those who are supporting you, we stand with you. We join our voices, the voices of all Canadians, to the millions of people around the world demanding that the Iranian government listen to their people, end the repression of freedoms and rights, and let women and all Iranians live their lives and express themselves peacefully. Today, I'm announcing that we will implement sanctions on dozens of individuals and entities, including Iran's so-called morality police. This is in addition to some of the toughest measures of any country towards Iran. Aujourd'hui, j'annonce qu'on va imposer des sanctions sur des douzaines d'individus et d'organisations, y compris la soi-disant police de la moralité iranienne. Aux femmes qui manifestent et à ceux et celles qui les soutiennent, on est là pour vous et avec vous.